Hey, welcome to the channel everybody. Sudhindra here again, and in this video let's look at the hot news coming about the upcoming Snapdragon processors which will be powering most of the flagship phones in 2021. But before we get there, if this is your first time here, I make videos on phones, cameras and everything tech. If this is of your interest, consider subscribing to the channel and ring the bell to get notified whenever I post an awesome tech video. Friends, only if you watch the video till the end and give it a like, YouTube will feature my videos in the searches. So please help me out here. 1st December is just 3 days away. That means Qualcomm is ready to launch its next generation flagship CPU along with its premium mid-range SoC. Yes, Snapdragon 875 and Snapdragon 775G are going to be launched on 1st December. And thanks to a famous Chinese tipster, we now know how powerful these chips are. In this video, let's talk about everything that we know about Snapdragon 875 and Snapdragon 775G. First, let's talk about the big dog in the room, Snapdragon 875. The prototype device running Snapdragon 875 has scored 740,000 AnTuTu points, which is roughly around 18-20% higher than already powerful Snapdragon 865 Plus powered phones, which maxed at 630,000 or 630,000 AnTuTu points. Coming to more details, it has one big Cortex X1 core which runs at 2.84 GHz, 3 Cortex A78 cores which runs at 2.42 GHz and 4 energy efficient Cortex A55 cores which run at 1.8 GHz. As far as the GPU, it is powered by Adreno 660, which is again 15-20% powerful than Adreno 650. And as we all know, it is built on a 5 nanometer fabrication. Now let's talk about its younger brother, which will be powering OnePlus Nord 2nd generation, the Snapdragon 775G. Unlike Snapdragon 875, where we know that it's built on 5 nanometer fabrication, we don't know what is 775G built on. What we know at the moment is the AnTuTu score of the prototype, which is powered by Snapdragon 775G, and it scores an impressive 530,000 or 530,000, opposed to Snapdragon 765G's 320,000 or 320,000. This is a substantial bump in performance, as much as 65% from Snapdragon 765G. Not just 765G, Snapdragon 775G is just 10% slower than Snapdragon 865, which is not even a year old. This is impressive, guys. With rumors suggesting Samsung powering their S21 lineup with Exynos 2100, I'm excited to see how fierce the competition is going to be in 2021. More than that, I'm interested to see if Qualcomm has any plans to launch a chipset which will compete with Apple's M1 chipset, or will it give 2-3 years head start to Apple and then struggle to catch up with Apple. I already made videos on budget 5G offerings coming to India. One of them, Moto G 5G, is coming in 2 days. You can find the video link popping up somewhere on the screen now. Go ahead and watch those videos. Well, that's all for this short video. I will update more details about this process once they are launched officially. Do let me know if you are ready to pay hefty price for the flagship processor, or if you are okay with a phone which is powered by a processor which is roughly 30% less powerful and almost 50% cheaper. If you like this video, do let me know by giving it a thumbs up, tweet it, share it, and if you haven't joined yet, join the Tech Platter family by hitting the subscribe button below. I'll see you in my next video.